You may cross-examine.
Mrs. Cromwell, do you consider yourself a friend of the defendant?
I do.
But you consider yourself a better friend of Mr. Hollister?
Well, I've known Ross longer. Before my husband died, he brought him into the business.
That the only reason?
I don't understand.
You are interested in Hollister, are you not?
Of course, my husband and I thought very highly of him.
Where is Mr. Hollister now?
I don't know.
Isn't that rather a peculiar way to run a business?
No. We're merchandising a new product. Mr. Hollister's on an extensive selling trip. He could be anywhere.
When was the last time you saw him?
On the afternoon of May 3rd, I dropped by his house.
Why?
There'd been some discrepancies in the company's books. Mr. Hollister was checking them for me, and I wanted his opinion before he left town.
And what was his opinion?
He hadn't finished. He was going to drop the books by Elaine's apartment, and I was to pick them up the following day.
Did you?
No, I couldn't get in. I was supposed to leave the key under the mat, but it wasn't there.
Where are those records now?
I have no idea.
Didn't you attempt to reach Mr. Hollister to find out?
It wasn't that important.
It was important to him before he left town.
No.
Important enough for him to make complicated arrangements such as borrowing the defendant's key and having you make a special trip to her apartment.
No, you don't understand.
Then we need clarification, Mrs. Cromwell. Would you please explain to this court why you, as a close business associate of Hollister's, wouldn't know his itinerary on this supposed business trip? And why, when the woman he loved was charged with murder, you failed to make one attempt to contact him?
Stop! Please stop!
Your Honor, I think this has gone quite far enough.